Community Health of New England's 61-day challenge is focusing on mind, body, and spirit for 2020. And this morning, it's all about our minds, specifically practicing mindfulness. And joining us now is Peter Callahan. He's the leadership coach at Copper Beach Institute, where he partners with organizations and individuals to train and experiment with mindfulness. Peter, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks so much for having me, Maggie. It's a pleasure.
All right, training our minds, like going to the gym, working out, training a muscle, it's fascinating. But I imagine if you hear that, you think, okay, it's a little daunting. Why are folks kind of weary getting into mindfulness, and why shouldn't they be?
Absolutely. I think there's three things we hear the most at Copper Beach Institute that I think really makes people a little bit hesitant. So often people will say, you know, it's too trendy. I'm not a hipster. I can't really sit in silence and close my eyes. It's just not for me. So that's number one. Number two is a misconception. And these are all, I think, in some ways misconceptions, but that it takes too much time, that I don't have half an hour or an hour to commit to a practice, which is completely unnecessary. But that's, we sort of have that built up in our heads. And then I feel like the other one is that most of us feel like we can't stop our thoughts. Right, we sit down and we try it maybe once and we say, well, there's just a ton going on in there. I actually seem a little crazy, so I think I'm going to avoid this at all costs because it just doesn't feel right, which are all really understandable, and we'll get to a little bit. But one point that I think is really helpful, that Dan Harris, the ABC News anchor who had a panic attack and now really espouses meditation through the 10% Happier brand, he talks about exercise not being a thing. So 50 years ago, if you were out running, somebody would ask, who's chasing you? Like, what are you doing? It was strange to exercise, right? We just didn't know about the science and how helpful it was. You know, we did some of those things, but the same thing is true with meditation. Now we're really just starting to learn all these benefits that it can have, but it doesn't feel like others are pressuring us to do it the way exercise sort of sits there. So it's growing. And I think we'll get there.
So before we wrap up, what are some of the benefits to practicing mindfulness that, you know, we can look forward to if we get into it?
Yeah, of course. I think a couple of benefits are it doesn't have to take a lot of time. So just getting a practice started, 1 or 2 minutes a day can really help us start to build a habit. And what a lot of people describe from doing this practice, and for me, I kind of say I'm a bit of a recovering jerk. So I did not used to treat people very well, or really judgmental in certain moments. And it's really helped me to notice when those thoughts come up and when I get frustrated and be able to respond, hopefully with something different instead of react. And just say that first thing that came to my mind. So being able to focus, regulate our nervous systems, which, you know, may not sound trendy, but it really, really helpful so that we could be the person we want to be. I think especially around this holiday season could be really helpful.
I think that's something we all could benefit from, myself included. So Peter, thank you so much for your time and your insight this morning. Really appreciate it. Great to have you on.
Thanks so much for having me, Maggie.